if you are watching my other video, my name is Fozzie the Kid, and this is the third week of my meniscus injury. And since then, I've been doing bicycle spinning. So I first start with my warm-up here that I'm doing. I started on a level of 15, and I just cruise through it. And then I increased the level and put it at 20. You know, when you increase the level, it gets a little bit more difficult. And it's just like to make it hard for me to pedal the bicycle, and that just warms up your knee in the right place, right behind your knee, on the meniscus. And then I go higher and I kind of like stand and pedal, which if you can do, is showing progress that your meniscus is actually doing better. For the third week now, I've been doing this almost like every day. Spinning is very crucial and very important. And then after that, you want to lower it and go back to like 5 or 10, and then just cruise, you know, just to lighten up that tension that you cause in the knee. And then here I attempted to stretch pretty much, activating your knee and your leg and just massaging your calves and behind your knee, where that is easier to kind of rub that meniscus. And it's a good feeling, it's a good relief. And just holding that stretch, you know, whenever there's pain in your meniscus, you want to make sure that you're stretching, you know, you're allowing blood to circulate in those regions of your leg, because that is very important, very necessary. And you know, you want to do it to the other leg too, though that is not injured. It's good to flex and stretch that leg just to keep flexibility going and to keep your leg even and balanced, in a sense. Just give it the same treatment, you know, pretend that it's also injured. You know, that leg is now is doing most of the work because your body weight is landing on one side and it's doing a lot of weight work than, you know, than usual. So, you know, give it the same treatment, you know. It's taking care of you, so you also take care of it. And I switch right to regular squat. So I start low and I slowly progress up, focusing, lifting your heels off the ground, and you know, burning your quads behind your glutes. Everything is isolated and you're just going up, you just focusing, going. As you notice, like whenever I get to that point where is you're bending or you're in a slight bend, you see my legs start to shake and I can't handle it's like your body weight. So you just, you know, focus mind muscle connection, and just go through it, you know. And you notice when I get to that point, my legs start to shake. It's like their mind and muscle connections are not engaged, you know, because there's also a tear in your muscle fiber. So you have to be very cautious of that. And then I do 4 sets of what I did previously, and then I get a band and I do 4 reps, and you want to do 3 sets of that. You see, as I'm going down, I'm controlling, and you see when I get to that point, I kind of get stuck. You just want to go through it. You're going to feel a slight pain. Now, I'm going to advise you that whenever you're going down and you see you drop like very fast and you can't control it, please do not do this workout, because that shows that your muscle is not healing yet. It's not healed to a point where it can do this kind of work. And you see, I do, and I also switch to a sumo stand and elevating my heel as well. And you want to go down, as you notice, like, look, my legs start to shake. And here we go. And then when you pass that point, it becomes all easier again. And then when you start to elevate, you're going to see what I'm talking about. My legs shaking. There you go. See that? That shake in there. You just want to focus and just continue going up, man. It's, you know, mind over muscle, you know, mind over matter. You just have to be strong-minded and just don't quit on a little slightest, like, tweak or hurt. And then I go again, another level. I take the rubber bands and I also go into the sumo position. You see my legs start to shake, like mind telling you to like stop, 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 stop. But don't give up. I mean, your body telling you to stop, but you don't give up, just continue to go. You want to do 4 reps of that as well, and 3 sets as well. And you'll notice, man, you'll get stronger and stronger. Remember, don't try to kill yourself. Just go at your own pace, you know. Some will even tell you for therapy, like, this is too advanced. Don't start doing stuff like this. You know your body more than anybody else. And another style, again, raising close leg, like in a regular squat position, how you do a regular squat. Leg close together, you know, in a arm shoulder width apart. Just want to control there and just continue going down and focus on that control, because that control is key. You'll notice, like, when you get to that level where it gets really difficult, you know, especially like going down is actually the hardest part for me, because you have to hold your body weight up on that leg. And another region of going up, when you get to that right there, you see that it starts to shake. It's like when you get to that half bent area, like when you're in a jump stand, that bent that you be having in your knee right in that position, that's where it's really difficult. And then I do a Y stand of what I just did, and same thing, man, like focus mind over body, whatever you think, that's what the body will do, you know. Yes, it might react and you know, and tell you like, hey, this is painful, telling your brain, hey, I feel pain, but just push through it, man. Don't let that pain cripple you, you know. Do the minimum, but do it often, you know, so you can recover faster. After that, I do the same thing again. I get the bands, and I do it in a sumo position, where with the band again, you just do the same thing, you know, just concentrate on the decentric movement or eccentric movement, you call it, and explode up. And you can see, I think the difficult part is that beginning, you know, when you get that slight bend in, that's the harder part, and then everything else just become easy, you know. And you will notice the changes in your leg muscle or feeling in your leg. You're walking a lot better, you're not limping. And then after that, I switch up to the sled. And the first one, you know, just going slow and just driving, you know, in that drive position is, you know, I feel a little bit, but it's not to where that, you know, it's so painful that you can't do it, you know. And start with a little weight, you know, don't try to be a macho man, and just focus on the drive, man. Like getting the strength back into your leg, into that effective lev is key, and that's where the key focus is at. So everything that you do, just do it slow. And then I added some more weight because I felt like, you know, I can do more. Do what your body will or can, you know. Don't try to, you know, just do it because you want to look cool, because you can actually hurt that knee back worse than it is. And as you see, I went heavier, but I'm still doing the same pace. I'm still doing that drive, like mountain climber position, and the same thing also back again. And just focus on the drive. Don't try to rush it, you know, feel it in that knee, you know. And then I start doing a reverse back pedal with the band. I'm using band right now, and also my jump rope, you know, I use that because the rubber band is kind of, it stretches, and then the weight was like rushing fast at me, and I wanted to keep it a constant steady pace, so I use both of them, and that was working for me. If you have a rope or something which you can tie around your waist, which is I preferred, which is also better. And then, you know, just keep a pace, man. Just try to lean back, but keep your back straight, you know. Keep that leg just under pressure or under tension, and just back pedal. As you can see, you want to stay on the ball of your feet, not on your heels. So you can isolate a muscle. And then I actually went heavier again on the sled because I felt really good about it. So I added more weight and I went faster than usual, which was pretty great. And because I was feeling good and I wanted to do some jump run, one leg isolation, and just to show that I'm recovering, I'm getting better, man, and just give it a try and let me know how it goes.